Hey everyone, today we'll be taking a look at something really interesting, a high-end M.2 SSD enclosure by ASUS, the TUF Gaming A1. You heard me right, ASUS has gone and upped the ante by producing a high-end version of an accessory that tends just to be functional in nature, so let's see what surprises the TUF Gaming A1 has up its sleeve. Starting first with the packaging. The TUF Gaming A1 comes in a box with graphics that pretty much follow the TUF Gaming design language. We're talking a silver on black color scheme with a touch of yellow thrown in for good measure. As always, we get a summary of the SSD enclosure's specs on the rear of the box. We'll run through some of these features later on in this video. In terms of what's included inside the box, first up we get a quick start guide. And this is accompanied by a multi-language user manual. Next up, we get the SSD enclosure itself. We'll set it aside for the moment so that we can see what else is included in the box. Next up, we get a USB Type-C to USB Type-C cable. And this is rounded off by an Allen key that allows you to open up the enclosure for the purposes of installing a SSD. Onto the aesthetics and build quality of the TUF Gaming A1. It's a hefty enclosure, alright, being constructed entirely of metal in a light metallic grey finish. On the front, it has an indicator LED up top and a TUF Gaming logo in black at the bottom. Moving over to the rear, we get a TUF Gaming motif printed onto the backplate of the SSD enclosure, and the said backplate is held in place by 4 hex screws. Finally, on the bottom short edge of the enclosure is the USB Type-C port. Now that aside, I have to say that the enclosure feels over-engineered, but in a good way, also probably due to its heft where it weighs in at 142 grams without an SSD installed. Now I don't quite know what to make of its design in terms of its inspiration, apart from the fact that it looks very military-like. Something like, I don't know, a cross between a mini jerry can and perhaps a remote detonation device? In any case, it sure looks pretty cool. In terms of the TUF Gaming A1's specs, it uses the USB 3.2 Gen 2 interface, which is rated for data transfer rates of up to 10 Gbps, and comes with a M.2 slot that supports both the NVMe PCIe and SATA interfaces. It also has the dimensions and weight that you see on the screen, and I guess the key highlight for this enclosure is its toughness, pun intended, where ASUS makes the claim that the SSD enclosure meets the US military's MIL-STD-810H standard when it comes to drop resistance. The enclosure also boasts an IP68 water and dust resistance rating. Given the TUF Gaming A1's imposing appearance, I'm pretty convinced that it would live up to its durability claims. With that, let's have a look at the insides of the TUF Gaming A1. To do so, we've just got to remove the backplate of the enclosure by simply undoing the 4 hex screws, like so. The insides of the SSD enclosure are not an overly complicated affair. We get a thermal pad on the backplate which helps with heat dissipation, and you'll also notice that there is a rubber gasket where the backplate comes into contact with the main body of the enclosure, which I suppose helps the enclosure achieve its IP68 dust and water resistance rating. The TUF Gaming A1 supports SSDs up to 2TB in capacity in the 2280, 2260 and 2242 form factors. One additional feature that the A1 has is what ASUS calls Q-Latch, which serves up a tool-free installation experience. Changing out the position of the Q-Latch to suit different SSD lengths is also a straightforward affair. Simply slide it out and replace it into the appropriate mounting hole and you're good to go. With that, to put the SSD enclosure through its paces, I'll be installing an ASUS ROG Strix SQ7 1TB NVMe SSD, and as you can see, installation is a breeze and shouldn't take up too much time. Now, to get a quick sensing of how the enclosure performs in terms of data transfer rate, I'll be hooking up the TUF Gaming A1 with the SQ7 SSD to my PC via its onboard USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C port. Thereafter, I'll run Crystal Disk Mark to see what kind of scores we'll be getting before rounding off with a quick file transfer test, where I'll move a 14.6GB video file from my PC's primary SSD to the SQ7. To put things into context, the ROG Strix SQ7 1TB NVMe SSD that I'm using for this test is rated by ASUS to have up to 7000 MB per second sequential read speeds and up to 6000 MB per second sequential write speeds. With that, the ASUS TUF Gaming A1 is a well-built premium SSD enclosure that, given its aesthetics, is bound to be a conversation starter for sure. As mentioned earlier, this enclosure only supports drives of up to 2TB in size, which in all honesty is a little bit of a bummer. Pricing-wise, I'm told by ASUS that the SSD enclosure will go on sale for a recommended retail price of SGD 79 in Singapore, which converts to roughly $57 for you international folks. Now, there's no denying this, the TUF Gaming A1 is not cheap, especially since SSD enclosures can be considered functional items that simply get the job done, where there are plenty of other offerings out there that can be had for a fraction of the A1's price. Of course, these cheaper offerings wouldn't have the bells and whistles that the A1 has. In view of this, if you're looking for a quality SSD enclosure that looks great, has water, dust, and shock resistance, the TUF Gaming A1 will definitely fit the bill with its over-engineered construction and interesting aesthetic. With that, thank you so much for watching. Do like and subscribe if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.